and promote, and want that more. You want the video because it'll make more if you want part one and then part two. Now, right in part one, I will have a note sheet here, a note sheet in the description below down here. Help me a emo hash it out if you have any questions about my disability. I try to answer most of them on here because I'm not gonna go into detail about them. So if you want to know more about my disability, you can look on the note sheet or you can comment down below and ask me to make a video on that particular part. So that's all my update I have for you right now. So let's get right into the video. Yay! So disability awareness video. Woo! My mic. Now, like I said in the previous video, mobility is a huge part for everyone that has cerebral palsy. Mobility is a huge part of their life no matter what, because cerebral palsy is a physical disability, not a mental. Not a mental disability. However, mental disability may be included in the type of cerebral palsy that the person may have, but mainly it's a mobility. I'm not saying that I can't do anything because I can do most of my by myself, but there are some things that I can't do by myself. So that's when my mobility is a hazard of my mic. I cannot hold myself up. So I use a wonderful tool on a walker, and I talk more about my walker in part one. So you can know that video out to see about my walker. Now, one thing that I think is really, really, really funny is at night I have trouble turning due to sometimes I have back pain due to a surgery that I had when I was 5 years old. It was called a dorsal myotomy. And I'm not gonna get into that in this video, but if you want another video on dorsal myotomy, I will certainly do so. But anyway, I have trouble turning at night because of the operation I hate. And Winnie, my dog, who is not in here, but I'm sure you all know her, is right next to me in bed at night, up above my back at night, and he won't move over. How I can't turn over at night. Oh, that's what I see. That's one thing that I see is really funny about my disability, because I can't turn and my dog won't let me turn at night. So I think that's really funny. Now I'm gonna get into what I can and cannot do due to my disability. And like I said, I am not gonna get into too much detail because I don't want this video to be too long and too boring. Oh, you guys, and I want to hit the base of cerebral palsy. However, I will go into that on the piece of paper that will be in the on my own, washing my water, and that awesome because that means I can go out with my hands, and hang out, and take walks around the neighborhood, and walk around with my dog, and go to, you know, and have fun. My favorite activity to do with my walk is probably take walks around the neighborhood with my best hand. That is my favorite activity in my walk, in addition to walking my wonderful dog, Winnie. So that having you know, I must absolutely adore it walking around the neighborhood with my hands. So walking around in my walker, I can do that. And I have a blast doing that because when we take walks, we talk about numerous different things about, you know, our internet. So I must my computer, and most of all, I must editing the video for you guys. You guys are awesome, and yeah, and in case you didn't know, we recently have 9 subscribers, so we're all almost at 10, you guys. Yay! I must ask you, and I must doing my laptop on my own. So that's another thing that I must do on my own. The next thing I can do on my own is hitting and handing up in my walker. So, you know, I can sit down, I can pull up in my walker and sit down by my chair, and I can hand up from a hitting permission by myself in my walker. However, I do worry about if I'm on tire or hardwood. So if I'm gonna hit myself down or hand myself up, I prefer to do it on hardwood because the water wheel do move and I worry about them moving too much. The next thing I can do on my own is open the hot door. I can open the hot door to my house by myself, which I must doing because in case you didn't know, I invite a ton of people over all the time and I must to answer the door by myself when I know my best hang or coming over. I will mentally wait in front of the hot window and wait more for them to pour up. And then when I know they are here, I'm like, yay, my best hang are here. And I will open the door all by myself, which is awesome. And the hot door is the only door in the house that I can open by myself because that has a really wonderful doorknob that I can turn by myself. So I'm not opening the door for my best hand or for my grandparents or whoever. I'm not having people over. That is my favorite summer activity, is having people over and spending time with my best thing. Yay! Now the next thing that I'm doing is more on my own, is going over to my hangout. Now I have a really best hen who messed up my feet. And I am able to in here. We play my apple. We talk. We hang out. I don't know what else we do. We play with a dog. We have the best time ever. So I met going to her house and having time on my own where I don't have to worry about anything. And I do bring my phone up to her house and think if I haven't seen my phone yet, that this is my phone and it's pretty awesome. And I do bring my phone up there and say I did need to call my mom or dad or something. I always have my phone when I'm up there. So those are the things that I can do on my own. Of course, there's a ton more, but I'm not gonna admit into that because we would be here all day, and I don't think you might want to be here all day. So, I know. And that's the way you live, and you move on with your meditation. So, I don't want anyone, you know, saying, oh, that must be so bad, because it's not. It's more like a unique present that I have meditation, because if I didn't have my disability and I didn't have, you know, meditation, I wouldn't be here today, you know, making the wonderful video about disability awareness. So, like I said, there are a lot of things that I can do on my own, and there are a lot of things I can't do on my own. So I miss my way out the good and the bad, and I figure out a way. I'm always looking for a way to improve myself. And if you want to improve yourself, you have to things that you need to work on. So the things that I can't do are things that I have to work on or that I may want to work on. So I can't knit dress on my own because, you know, they're hard. I can't knit undress on my own. I can't do hair care, like brushing my hair and brushing my teeth. I can't knit mitt in and out of my hair. And those are the things I can't do, but luckily I have wonderful people around me that are willing to help me with the few things that I need help with. And of course, there's always going to be more things that I need help with. But I'm not, you know, it doesn't hold me back any. I'm not doing what I do. And thank you for all the wonderful people that help me with everything that I can't do, that I can't do on my own. You've